James Molloy has a particular style and aspiration to save. When a craftsman, consistently a craftsman. This turned out to be obvious to us when we found the UK's James Molloy while he was on vacation. Presently the worldwide makeup minister for Rimmel London, Molloy initially examined craftsmanship and worked in visual promoting before propelling into a makeup profession. His makeups have graced the pages of distributions including Vogue, L'Officiel and Harper's Bazaar, and his big-name customers incorporate Dita Von Teese, Emma Watson and Kanye West. Peruse on to perceive what he needs to state about his style and profession, his makeup school and his devices and frill brand, MyKitCo. Makeup artist, what town in the north of England would you say you are from? It is safe to say that you are as of now situated in Stockport close to the MyKitCo HUB? James Molloy, I'm initially from Stokesley, a little market town in North Yorkshire. I left there when was 18 and moved to Manchester, which has consistently been a genuinely lively city. I visited in my initial youngsters, when the hacienda was all the while occurring, and becoming hopelessly enamored with the city. I as of now invest my energy between Stockport, where my MyKitCo and my school are based, and London, where my organization, Premier, is based. Mama, take me back to the start. What made you need to turn into a makeup craftsman? JM, I genuinely didn't understand that being a settle-on-up craftsman was a profession decision until I left my old neighborhood. I generally had an interest with magnificence and craftsmanship. My fantasy was to be a comic book artist. I've generally portrayed, painted, made things from pieces of material. I'm very involved, if a touch of ailing in persistence. I grew up tuning in to symbols, for example, Madonna, Boy George and Debbie Harry, and watching motion pictures like Barbarella with Jane Fonda, and I was fixated by their style. I previously found makeup out traveling to Manchester, where I passed by the city's first MAC counter. I was shocked by the makeup application, dark uniform and the way that there were folks doing makeup. It felt like I had a place behind that counter with them. Mama, how did you figure out how to do makeup? Who was the primary individual you put makeup on? JM, I think my adoration for craftsmanship and slight fixation on excellence symbols helped me get familiar with the rudiments of magnificence before long. I handled a full-time position at MAC, having never done makeup. I was so anxious to learn, and the preparation was the best in the business. I was fortunate enough to have my essential MAC preparing with Terry Barber, who instructed me that makeup doesn't need to approach lovely, it very well may be male, female, extreme, fun-loving, anything you need it to be, and that it's the same amount of about an inclination as an extraordinary application. Mama, how did you get your beginning in the business? JM, I surmise my huge break was being elevated to the MAC Senior Craftsman Group. I'd been with the brand for a long time whenever the open door went along. This opened up the universe of behind-the-stage magnificence and the global shows, where I truly tweaked my abilities. Mama, what did your situation with MAC involve? JM, after 10 years with MAC in the UK, I moved to Hong Kong as the chief for makeup aestheticness for Asia Pacific. My locale had 12 nations, including Korea, Japan, China and Australia. Just as press speaking to the brand, I likewise created imaginativeness programs and coached the area's senior craftsman group. Mama, what, when was your first significant industry work? Who accomplished you take a shot at and for what? JM, I'd as of late moved to Hong Kong and was approached to enter the machinos appear in Shanghai. The creation was colossal, 60 models and a huge amount of press. I think it indicated individuals that I could key a major show and handle the weight, just as turn out a wonderful look.